In this video, we're going to talk about what are called distance rate time problems, and I've written one here for us. Let's go ahead and read it together. A plane flies 1,500 miles in 3 hours with the wind. Flying the same distance against the wind takes 3 hours and 45 minutes. And the question we're asked is this: how fast does the plane fly in still air, and how fast is the wind? Okay, so to begin thinking about what they're asking for, let's imagine you had the following situation. Let's say that you had what's called a moving sidewalk. So let's say the moving sidewalk was going this way at 3 miles per hour. And let's say on that moving sidewalk, there was a cat. And so here's our cat. All right, cat is smiling. Okay, and let's say the cat is walking this direction at 7 miles per hour. Okay, now you as an observer, you're watching this cat walk on the moving sidewalk, okay? So you see a total of the cat walking at 10 miles per hour. So the total is 10 miles per hour. This is what you see from the side. Why? Because if the cat's speed is A and this speed is B, well, what you're basically seeing is when 1 hour passes, the cat alone walking by itself can go 7 miles per hour, but the sidewalk itself is moving at 3 miles per hour. So after 1 hour, the cat has actually gone 10 miles because it's got a little help from the sidewalk. So we got the 10 by simply adding A and B together. Okay, and now imagine the following situation similar to that. So once again, it's a moving sidewalk, but now the moving sidewalk's going that way at 3 miles per hour. And once again, we have our little cat. And let's see if I can draw this kitty again. Okay. And the cat's now going, still this way, let's say at 7 miles per hour. Now you from the side, what do you actually see? Well, the cat's trying to go 7 miles per hour, but it's actually losing ground, right? Because it's walking on a sidewalk that's going that way. So after 1 hour, the cat hasn't gone 7 miles. You had to take away the 3 miles that the sidewalk sort of pulling it back the other direction. That is, in this case, the total is not 10, right? It's actually less than 7. It's going to be 4 miles per hour. And once again, if this is A, and if that, right, is B, how did we get the 4? Well, we took A and we subtracted B. So A take away B. That's how we got the 4, okay? So with this in mind, we're gonna tackle our problem here. So we've got 15 miles in 3 hours with the wind, and flying the same distance against the wind takes 3 hours and 45 minutes. How fast does the plane fly in still air, and how fast is the wind? Okay, so let's go to a new page here. So first of all, let's identify what we're looking for. We're looking for two things, right? So we're gonna say, first of all, let x equal the plane speed in still air. So this is kind of like the cat walking. This is how fast the cat can walk when not on a moving sidewalk, okay? So a plane, is just flying in still air, no wind. So the wind in this example is kind of like the moving sidewalk in the previous example. And we're also asked for the wind speed, right? So y is going to be the speed of the wind. Okay, now we want to organize our information, and we're going to create a little table to do so. This table I recommend using whenever you have a rate time distance problem. Okay, let me go ahead and create that little table now and talk to you about how to fill it in. Okay, so this is the basic outline for the table. We have two rows and we have three columns, column one, column two, and column three. Column one is gonna be rate, and we're just gonna write that as an R. Column two is gonna be time, and we'll write that, we'll label that with a T. And column three will be distance, and we'll label that with a D, okay? So that's how it always goes in these problems. We're always gonna have three columns: rate, time, and distance. Now it's time to label the rows. And the rows are labeled according to the parts of the problem you have. So for example, you know, we have a plane, and what's the plane doing? Well, it's flying with the wind, and then it's flying against the wind. So that's how I'm going to label these rows. With the wind, and then against the wind. Okay, and that's how these rate-time-distance problems, or distance-rate-time problems, always go. You always want to think about the journey and break it up into different legs, and then label for each of the legs you're going to have a row. Now, do you see how I have six squares here? Each little square has a meaning associated with it. For example, this square is the distance that the plane goes with the wind. Okay, and this square would be the rate that the plane goes against the wind. And then one more just to make sure that we've got the hang of it. This square, for example, is the time that the plane goes against the wind. Okay, so every square has a meaning, a physical meaning associated with it. And I like to start off by filling in what I call the easy information. So the easy information is information that's given right away in the problem. And if you remember, well, the plane went 1,500 miles, right, with the wind. So the distance with the wind is easy. It's 1,500 miles. So I'll write that in here. Okay, now what about, is anything else easy? Well, yeah, the plane went the same distance against the wind, right? So this is also 1,500. Okay, and so was anything else easy information? In other words, can we just fill in anything else right away? Well, if you recall, the time with the wind, that was 3 hours. Okay, and notice how I'm not putting units here. I'm aware that distance is in miles and time is in hours. Okay, I'm just not writing the units here because it's a little inconvenient to have that in the table. And what was the time against the wind? Well, that was 3 hours and 45 minutes, right? Now, 45 minutes is 3/4 of an hour. So let's write that as 3 and 3/4 of an hour. Now that's often convenient to, it's often convenient to write this, which is a mixed number, as an improper fraction. So 4 times 3 is 12 and 12 plus 3 is 15. So I'm going to write that as 15/4. Okay, at this stage, notice how you have, you know, for this row, for example, notice how I have 2 out of the 3 squares filled in. Now, it turns out one of the perks in these problems, one of the great things about these problems, is if that's the case, if you have 2 out of the 3, you always get the third for free. And the reason is because of this relationship, that rate multiplied by time is always equal to distance. Okay? Now, what that means is that if you know 2 out of the 3, you can get the third. So, for example, on this first row, I know what the time is, I know what the distance is, and I can get the rate because the rate here, if I want to get the rate by itself, all I have to do is divide the distance by the time. Okay, so likewise, the distance divided by the time, well, 1,500 divided by 3, that's equal to 500, right? So this is 500. Let me try that again. So in this rate, with the wind, I get that right away. It's going to be 500. Okay, and the same thing holds here, right? This rate is this distance, which is 1500, divided by that time. Now, this is a little bit awkward to put in this square, so I'll go ahead and do this off to the side. What is 1500 divided by 15 over 4? That's what I'm doing, right? Well, that's equal to 1,500 over 1 times 4 over 15. And let's see, 15 goes into 1,500 100 times. And 4 times 100 is 400. So this is 400. Okay. Now, when you have your table completely filled in, it's time to create your equations. Now, do you see how you have two unknowns here? You have x and you have y. Whenever you have two unknowns, that tells you that you're going to need two equations. So we want to think back to our previous page with the cat on the little moving sidewalk. So the cat on the sidewalk is like the plane with the wind. So let's think about this for a second. When the plane is going with the wind, its speed is 500 miles per hour. Well, how did the plane get going so fast? Well, that's like asking, how did the cat look like it was walking so fast? Didn't you add the cat's speed to the speed of the moving sidewalk? And that's what we're doing here, right? To get 500, you've got to take the plane speed in still air and add it to the wind speed. So this 500 you get by taking X and adding it to Y. Right? It's like the cat speed plus the moving sidewalk speed. And likewise, when the plane's flying against the wind, that's like the cat walking against the sidewalk, right? So in this case, it's the plane speed, but take away the speed of the moving sidewalk, right? Which is Y. And when you do that, you get the rate of the plane against the wind, which is 400. Okay, now that you have what's called a system of equations, right? Now you can see why we needed two equations. We can solve this. And the easiest way to solve this one is simply by using what's called the addition method. So for the addition method, you recall, you simply add the equations together. In this case, you get 2x is equal to 900. So if you divide both sides by 2, you get x is equal to 450. Now, what does x represent? X was the plane of the speed of the plane in still air. So this is the plane speed. In still air. And then likewise, you're asked to find the speed of the wind. Well, what's true? Well, x plus y is 500. So if x is 450, then y clearly has to be 50. So that 450 plus 50 gives 500. So y is, in this case, 50. And that's the speed of the wind. Okay, and then both of these are in miles per hour. So this would be your answer. Now, the key to these problems is setting up this table. And so what we do is we set up the table, fill in the easy information, and then create a system of equations involving our unknowns. And that's how you solve distance rate time problems.